Hello, I'm Vandini Arya. In this video, I'm going to talk about how do you deal with the negative feedback. Basically, you are running a business, the customers will give you the negative feedback. When you run a business, you will get feedback that might be either positive or negative. You might think and get worried about how I will deal with the negative feedback. I think it's better for you to take the positive side of both feedbacks, either the negative or the positive. It might come from a customer who walks into your business, or if you run an online store, the negative feedback might appear on social media or might write to you right on your website or Twitter, anywhere. When you read that, you will become upset and worried. But the essential thing here is to deal with that in a calmly way. At the same time, you cannot ignore any negative feedback, because if you do not take immediate action to correct it, the customer will leave you, and they will not only that, they will go and spread the word and about the negative feedback. People are very keen on spreading the word about negativity, but they take time to talk about positivity. That is the normal thing happening in the business world today. It might affect you personally, but you have to look at the right side of it. Because if a customer leaves you without saying any mistakes in your business, you will not know. You will continue to do the same thing, and you will not be aware of the mistakes you are making. You must be so, you have to be grateful to the customer who has given you the negative feedback about some mistakes, some accidental mistakes or whatever it is, mistakes happening in your business. So that gives you an opportunity to correct it. At least even if that particular customer leaves, you will not lose your potential customers. That is the important thing. That is the best part of the negative feedback. Therefore, it is essential to you, you have to be grateful to the customer for sharing the knowledge with you as you learn the correction from your mistakes. Sometimes, some clients, this is a bit tricky also, but I have to explain that here as well. Sometimes some clients make mistakes in giving you the negative report without realizing they made the original mistakes, which prompted you to make a mistake. I'll give you an example here. Have you seen a business owner making changes every month in hiring and dismissing staff? Besides, there is no definite number of hours they work, resulting in lots of complications in maintaining the payroll records. It's not easy. Then the same business owner goes and does the purchase a vast variety of different types of products for small amounts, for about $2, $3 of money from most part of the world, and expected to do the bookkeeping without making a single mistake. Is that possible? I do not think so. There could be mistakes. So this particular owner does not understand the tax systems and starts to find fault with the staff who is doing the bookkeeping, comes out with all negative remarks. I think the best solution to quietly leave the client to go who lacks specific basic knowledge in running a business, does not trust anyone, it is not worth having a client like that, because it will affect your reputation in the long run. Therefore, in all situations, mistakes are not entirely yours, but you want to keep your reputation as a business person. It is better to leave people like that. However, all that said, cannot ignore negative reviews and answer within 1 or 2 days. Then you have a more significant responsibility to prove yourself as a trustworthy entrepreneur in the potential to the potential customers the best way to offer a replacement for a new product. If they don't want the new product from you, immediately refund the money. That's the best way to calm them down. And to maintain your brand, you have to maintain your brand without any damage. Whatever happens, you should never lose your politeness towards your clients. That's very important. Which is escalate the disputes. Besides, it would help if you showed your concerns and compassion towards your clients. This is all true. This is all what's happening in today's competitive world of business. I hope you like these tips if you're a small business owner. Thank you very much for watching my video. Thank you. I'll talk soon. Thank you. Bye for now. Thank you.